tonight, a Target 12 investigators exclusive taxpayer taxi. We've discovered the state's top legislators are being taken for a ride, and you're footing the bill. Our investigation reveals the Senate President and House Speaker each have a car and driver at their disposal, paid for with your tax dollars.
Tonight, we're raising questions about how this pricey perk is being used by one of them. Let's get right to Target 12 investigator Tim White for the exclusive details.
These cars are fueled with taxpayer dollars, so they should be used for state business. But we found that wasn't always the case.
It's the biggest political fundraiser of the year in the heart of campaign season, the Rhode Island Democratic Party's annual Unity Dinner. Anyone who is anyone in the Democratic Party is there, including one of the most powerful elected officials in the state, Senate President Teresa Pivoweed. And make no mistake, this is a partisan fundraiser. Donations are $35 a seat or $1,500 a table. Campaign finance reports show the Senate president went big, the maximum amount of $1,500. That night, we watch as this SUV comes to pick her up. But this isn't the Senate president's personal car. It's yours, a taxpayer-bought and maintained Ford Explorer with a publicly funded state employee at the wheel. The driver waits for an hour and a half. Finally, she emerges, a goodbye from staffers, and the Senate president departs. The taxpayer taxi drives her all the way from the political fundraiser in Boroughville, 48 miles to her home in Newport, a trip that took 1 hour. The driver then leaves Newport and hikes it all the way back to the state house. He drops the Senate car off at 10:30 at night.
Do you think that's an appropriate use of the vehicle?
The night of the Unity Dinner, I believe we actually had another event.
Senate President Teresa Pivoweed says she thinks it's okay because she was driven there in a private car after a speaking engagement elsewhere.
The policy that I have had here in the office has been to go in a private vehicle if there's a political event and be picked up at the political event to be brought home. And those rare occasions when I'm dropped off or picked up, it would be a very rare occasion.
Records reveal both the Senate vehicle and one assigned to the Speaker of the House were purchased for a total of $59,000. They cost $7,500 a year to maintain. That's not including fuel or the payroll for staffers who drive it.
Beyond the ethical question of how this car was used, there's the question of whether a state in dire financial straits can even afford it.
We checked with our neighbors in Massachusetts, where they have a full-time legislature, as well as Connecticut with a part-time assembly like ours. Neither state supplies their top legislators with a taxpayer-funded car or driver. But in Rhode Island, the taxpayer taxi is getting a lot of use. We spotted the Senate president meeting with a fellow senator at a Providence restaurant. For more than an hour, a staffer waits in the car. On another occasion, the car picks her up at a meeting with city and town leaders in Warwick. And again, takes her over the Newport Bridge to drop her home. The driver then has to drive all the way back to the state house.
Certainly, I inherited the state vehicle. It was a tradition. The vehicle was acquired in 2007 prior to me becoming the Senate president.
House Speaker Gordon Fox also has a car assigned to him with a paid aide behind the wheel. Records show the House vehicle used by Fox has 29,000 miles on it. The Senate car used by Pivoweed has 80,000 miles. Remember, they were bought at the same time. We've seen Fox use the car for daytime meetings and lunch with a colleague. We did not witness the House Speaker use it at any partisan events.
Clearly during the campaign season, as a defined season, I never use it, and I'm very sensitive to that.
We wanted to know how else this car has been used over the years, but we're told they don't track that. We've learned other senators can use the car with permission. Already, this report is prompting possible change at the State House. I'll have that development for you tomorrow on Eyewitness News at 6. With the Target 12 investigators, Tim White, Eyewitness News.
The investigation continues online, including details on how much the drivers make.
Plus, a look at other top politicians who have drivers and why the circumstances are different. It's all on WPRI.com.